site than it is in Ehrenberg, which is actually kind of unusual. Still over $4 a gallon though, so that's pretty painful. But that's the way it is. Taking the Business Loop 10 into Quartzsite. I've never done that before. That's the first time I got to see the welcome sign with the camel silhouettes on it. High Jolly was the camel herder.
In 1¾ miles, turn right on South Cove Avenue.
For the Army in this area, and, well, not in this area particularly, but he died here, and there is a monument to High Jolly and his camel. Oh, there's another camel on the side of the road there. Yeah, I've actually never come into town from this direction. I've always come from the west heading east.
In 1½ mile, turn right on South Cove Avenue. In 1½ mile, turn right on South Cove Avenue.
I just pulled in here to Solar Bills, wondering if it's possible to get an estimate on what it would cost to get me what I need. So this is the last camp of High Jolly, marked by the pyramid of native stone, marking the resting place of the Greek born in Syria, also known as Philip Tedro, and Haji Ali. High Jolly was hired in 1857 as a camel herder in the U.S. Army's short-lived historic camel corps by Lieutenant Edward F. Beale in his expedition to chart a wagon road across New Mexico and Arizona, ending at the Colorado River. In 1861, the Civil War commenced, ending the day of the Camel Corps. High Jolly returned to Quartzsite, trying his hand at mining, packing, scouting, delivering the jackass mail, and selling water to travelers. Quartzsite Cemetery is named in High Jolly's honor. Topped by the camel. Pretty cool looking pyramid. Doesn't say that he's actually buried here, though. But, nice little cemetery. So there you have it. No, actually I need to dump and get water.
Okay, dump station's on the other side of the brown fence. There's
okay.
Two already there.
Okay.
And the water is flowing.
And how much?
What's the length on your rig, huh?
24.
So it'll be 14 altogether.
Okay, cool.
10 for dump, 4 for water.
Let me start with water because I got someplace I need to be, and if they're still hanging out, then I'm just going to do water and I'll dump later.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
I'll pay you after.
You just pay $4 then for your water. And come back and.
All right.
Yeah, pull over to the right and right behind that other motorhome. We have that second station there.
Okay, perfect.
The three red ones down the center there.
Yep, thank you.
Springs Road.
Okay, am I going to be able to find a place to park?
Your destination is on the left.
Well, you may be able to tell that this is not the trip to Joshua Tree that I was hoping for, starting with the fact that I was there fairly early in the morning and all the RV parking was taken up by cars. Got out of the visitor center, had some ideas about things to go check out, but as it turns out, every single place throughout the park where there was any parking was completely jam-packed. There was not a single place for me to be able to park. So basically I drove through and then headed on to my destination for the evening, which was in Sky Valley. So stay tuned for tomorrow. After a good night's sleep, I decided it was time to check out the world's largest crochet museum, with both interior and exterior photos. And then there was all this other quirky stuff in the same parking lot that we got to take a look at. So check it out. Let me know what you think.
All right, so I came here for a specific thing, which is over here on the left. We'll get there in a minute. But there is so much more here than I expected to see. This is actually a very, very cool stop. Got a carved tree here. Lots of cacti. Check out this garage that's been repurposed into an art studio. Let's check it out real quick. Yeah, how cool is this? There's a thing. cool trailers. Looks like they do some performances, got a stage set up. Yeah, this was much more than I was expecting. I guess this is an alien installation? Not quite sure. Cool looking though. And then here's what I actually came for. Is the world famous crochet museum. There's Quirk. And then bunch of talking heads, Wheels of Fortune. Okay, I think this definitely qualifies for Quirky. Oh, more carved logs back there. And then this is actually really cool. You can stand inside and get your picture taken, but the stone forms the outline for the person and around the copper moon, and then it's all framed with the blue wood. Pretty cool, guys. All right, definitely a good Quirky stop. All right, so I'm in the back alleys of Joshua Tree right now. There's the Undertaker over there. Look at the cool school bus, gift shop, dentistry. Sorry, it's like really bumpy. We can barely move without doing damage. Fortune teller. All right, this was definitely worth the stop.
Hey, thanks for hanging out with me. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, I'd appreciate it if you subscribe, hit that thumbs up button, and always remember to sally forth, live your best life, go out and adventure in whatever way works for you.